sperm donation is very common, but people don't talk about it. I'm a nobody in film industry right now. You know, I trust my director so much because I'm a newbie.
Tell us something about your the kind of stuff, the kind of movie that you've grown up on, the theater that you've done and grown up on, and which tells us more about your likes in cinema.
Yeah, frankly speaking, I'm a simpleton from Chandigarh. I had a very normal childhood, totally Bollywood. My father loves watching films, my mother loves watching films, and they're like encyclopedia of Bollywood. So I think it's a right balance between being earthy and being somebody on a youth channel, which is slightly cool. But again, I think being myself, being simple, is my USP.
You're basically from Chandigarh, and obviously Punjabi, I'm sure, must be coming naturally to you as well. Hindi movies, they are hugely popular in all the Punjabi belts of India, as well as abroad, be it UK, yeah. USA, Australia, everywhere in fact. And is it an advantage for you that since you're having that Punjabi element, and if given a role which is based on, say, Haryanvi and Punjabi element, because iska market bahut solid hai.
I think most of the people who come from outside Bombay, they have this advantage. They come with a certain cultural baggage. I'm a Punjabi, and I can read and write in Punjabi, so it'll really help me a lot. Bombay culture is slightly, it's like a Bhelpuri. It's the only metropolitan city in the country. You lose your identity. I meet Punjabis who can't speak in Punjabi in Bombay. I meet South Indians who don't know their language. So I think it's very important to know your language.
There's a certain observation that you have a lot of confidence. That confidence, some would say that maybe it has a tinge of a rebel as well. You say that jis tarike se main Hindi bol sakta hun, baki yahan ke log nahi bol pate hain. Then you're referring to Mumbai as Bombay, which I'm absolutely fine with. I love it. Okay, so youngestan or
the best part is I can afford to fool around. I can afford to make statements which are politically not correct, because I'm not a star right now. So let me live my life right now. Maybe 5 years down the line, if I become a star, I may not become one. But
no, inshallah, you will. I really hope that you will. And we'll keep this interview for that. We'll show him. Look, you were at that time natural. Now you are diplomatic statements.
That's so sweet of you. I don't know. But yeah, right now I can be blunt and honest.
The music video we're just watching, in fact, and you're having Ugta Suraj prastut karta hai, and you're having all sorts of sperms, the playful, the sporty, and the lover and the flirtatious, the sleazy and stuff like that. I was there at HT brunch the other day, and the host was telling us that in fact John Abraham himself said that there are many cases of people who actually go for these sort of sperm donations, because people who are not conceiving, unke liye ek bahut hi zyada ek life mein ek vacuum hota hai. In fact, I asked Shujit as well that it is a serious subject. One would want to, maybe one would conceive that maybe it should be a serious subject, but aap usko ek light-hearted tarikhe se le rahe. There will be a very thin line. You'll be walking on a thin line, because if you just digress, or if you just step on someone's toes, or it is a sensitive topic after all. How have you dealt with that?
In fact, Shujit Dai did a lot of research. He visited sperm banks, met all the sexologists, and he did his homework well, I think, before going on floor. That's why I waited for 4 years, for the right director, and he's really credible. We've seen his work in the past, though nobody has seen Shoe Bite, Johnny Mastana, which he made with Amitabh Bachchan. But I've seen the film twice. It's amazing. It's out of the world. It should get released for the sake of good cinema. You know, I trust my director so much, because I'm a newbie. I'm a nobody in film industry right now. But he's a brilliant guy. He's given me a lot of space, and the amount of homework he's done on this issue, it's incredible. It's just that sperm donation is very common, but people don't talk about it. The first incident was in 1884, when a Swedish surgeon impregnated impregnated a lady successfully using her husband's sperms. But it became public in 1954 according to British Medical Journal. Even in India, there are a lot of sperm banks who are conducting a lot of awareness programs in IIT or different institutes, because they want young, vital sperms. But yeah, even if we do something like a street play, which raises a lot of social causes or issues, I think we need to present the issue in a very light-hearted way, because it's a commercial commercial cinema, and we need eyeballs, we need people to see the film. So we have to take it in a light-hearted way. We can't really make a documentary out of it. Nobody wants it.
Right. What are your future plans after this?
I don't know. Yeah, I think we all make our plans, and they may
fail.
You're
doing one more film.
Yeah.
Give us a.
Yes,
clear answers.
Of course,
one more film. Shuja Sarkar.
I'm just looking for the right second film.
And the right second film you have been offered. What is the name?
Actually, I'm reading scripts for the second film. Yeah, but I've not finalized any of them. But I'll talk about Hamara Bajaj, the second film with Shujit Sarkar. It's a story of a small town guy from Agra who wants to be an actor.
Like
struggling actor. Yeah, it's called Hamara Bajaj. Name of the character is Sanju Bajaj.
Hamara Bajaj. You know, before you came, I was just speaking to Mr. Alec Padamsi, the guy who coined that term, Hamara Bajaj. The entire campaign for Bajaj was
it's
done
tentatively
by
titled, by the way.
Tentatively.
So, yeah.
But it's interesting.
Yeah, it is.
It is interesting. So fantastic. That was Ayushman. I think the star of today, for sure, at least Bollywood Hungama star of today, and kal Hindustan ke star hone wale hain, aur inshallah puri duniya bhar mein wo naam karenge. And very interesting conversation that we had. And the best part is that he has made some really fun, politically incorrect statements, which was the best part, because personally, we love interviews which are not diplomatic and it comes straight from the heart, and which is exactly what has happened. And he also recited a very good poem that he has written. It's called Hawa. And we really hope that that you do extremely well. The promos are looking very good of your film. And we hope that next year, aapko sare debutant aapko awards mile, and all the best wishes.
Thank you so much, Faridun. So yeah, 20th April it is. Vicky Dhawan.
That's all we have from Bollywood Hungama. Keep on watching.